Coagulase test. Coagulases are enzymes that clot blood plasma by a mechanism that is similar to normal clotting. The coagulase test identifies whether an organism produces this exoenzyme. The coagulase test is used to differentiate Staphylococcus aureus from coagulase-negative staphylococci. Staphylococcus aureus produces two forms of coagulase, that is bound coagulase and free coagulase. Bound coagulase, otherwise known as clumping factor, can be detected by carrying out a slight coagulase test, and free coagulase can be detected by doing a tube coagulase test. Coagulase can tightly bound to the surface of Staphylococcus aureus and coat its surface with fibrin upon contact with blood. It is also proposed to fibrin-coated staphylococci resist phagocytosis, thereby increasing the virulence capability of the bacteria. Procedure. The slight coagulase test. This method measures bound coagulase. The bound coagulase is also known as clumping factor. Materials required. Clean glass slides, divided into two sections as controlled and test. Sterile distilled water. Resuspended coagulase rapid plasma. Culture of the test organism. Sterile needles. Procedure. Arrange all the materials in the laminar airflow. Place a small drop of distilled water on each side of the slide labeled as control and test. Heat the loop and transfer one or two colonies of the test organism from the nutrient agar plate to each drop and emulsify to make a smooth suspension. Reheat the loop. Now transfer one drop of resuspended rabbit plasma to the test suspension and mix well with a sterile needle. Do not put anything in the other drop that serves as a control. Results. Within 5 to 10 seconds, clumping of cocci was observed in the area marked test, and the control region, no visible clumps were observed, which indicates the presence of coagulase positive Staphylococcus aureus. Some strains of Staphylococcus aureus may not produce bound coagulase, and such strains must be identified by tube coagulase test. Tube coagulase test. Materials required. 3 sterile test tubes labeled as test, negative control, and positive control. Resuspended coagulase rapid plasma. Test organism. Culture of Staphylococcus aureus, which serves as positive control. Sterile nutrient broth. Procedure. Each tube is filled with 1 ml of 1 in 10 dilute rapid plasma. Add 0.2 ml of overnight broth of the test tube organism to the tube labeled test. Then add 0.2 ml of overnight broth culture of Staphylococcus aureus to the tube labeled positive control. Also add 0.2 ml of sterile broth to the tube labeled negative control. All these tubes are incubated in a water bath maintained at 37 degrees Celsius, and suspensions were observed at half hourly intervals for a period of 4 hours. Results. Clot formation within 4 hours of incubation was observed in the test culture and is interpreted as a positive result and is indicative of a virulent Staphylococcus aureus strain. All pathogenic strains of Staphylococcus aureus are coagulase positive, whereas a non-pathogenic species, that is Staphylococcus epidermidis, are coagulase negative. While slight coagulase test is useful in screening, tube coagulase test is useful in confirmation of coagulase test.